everybody, it's Lou Collins and thank you for joining me. Today I've got a very quick die cutting and stamping trick for you, particularly for when you're using those stamps with the dies that overlay or cut the outline of. Now it's all about lining these up. How many times have you stamped and even then gone ahead and coloured in a stamped image only to get it slightly wrong when you're cutting it with the outline die? So I'm going to be using my own textures brand, and I've got quite a large stamp here and a large outline die so I can clearly show you the technique. But of course this will work with your smaller dies. So for example, when you stamp and die cut florals and things like that. Everything I'm using today, like I say, is from a textures range and I will link them down below. So let's get started. So the first thing I need to do, of course, is stamp my image. I tend to like to stamp and then die cut before I do any sort of colouring, because very often in the past it's the die cutting that's actually gone wrong and I've got it slightly offset to one side or another, and I've been really disappointed when I've cut that out incorrectly and I've just spent all that time colouring in and adding all the detail in. So I would always do my cutting first. Now for this technique you're going to need two pieces of paper. One of the paper or cardstock is going to be what you're stamping onto in your final piece, and the other is just a scrap piece that is larger than your stamp and die cut. So this one is from my steampunk range and it's the steampunk typewriter. Absolutely love this one. So there we go, look at the detail in that. A gorgeous stamp, I adore it, I use this all the time. So like I say, I wouldn't go in and add any colour or even any other details to the paper at the moment. I'll just pop my platform out of the way. And now I need to line up my die. Now, like I say, this is a large image, so this wouldn't be too difficult for me to line up. But there is still an element where you can't quite see where the cutting blades are because of the size of the die on the outside there. So I'm going to bring in another piece of cardstock. I've purposely used for this a larger piece and a nice bright colour so that you can really see what I'm doing. And all I'm going to do is, just with a low tack tape, tape down my outline die onto this scrap of cardstock here and run that through my machine. So I'm just looking to cut the outline. I'm not worrying about stamping it onto this piece of cardstock. And once you've done this for each of your dies, of course you can then keep that and use it time and time again. Try to use for this a cardstock or even a paper that isn't too thick, because you're going to want to go through two layers later. So you want to make sure that you can easily get through those. Now this I'm going to discard. I don't need that anymore. I'm going to pop my plates away. So now what I can do is I can lay my outline over the stamped image and position it so that it's exactly where I want it. So I can jiggle that about by the millimeter. And then all I need to do is take some tape, and in this case, because my cardstock is a very similar size to the piece underneath, I'm going to wrap my tape around the cardstock. I'll do this in a couple of places so that that can't move. Just make sure before you put your second piece on that again you're really happy. There we go. Okay, so now all we need to do is take our outline die, give this a jiggle about and pop it into where you've just cut into that green. You'll find it will slide in really easily. So once you've popped that in, a little bit of tape just to keep it secure. You can pop tape somewhere else as well if you want to, but that should sit nicely within that top die cut of the green. And we can now run this back through our die cutting machine. And this is where, as I said to you, you don't want to use a cardstock for the green layer that's too thick. Obviously, it doesn't need to be green. Because you're going through two pieces of cardstock here. Now most thin dies will easily cut through two layers of 200-250 GSM cardstock. And there we go, we've got an absolutely perfect die cut, and I've also got myself actually two templates now that I can use every time I stamp this image and want to cut it out. Like I say, for this stamp and die set, I am linking the products below so you can go and find those available at Craft Stash. But try this out on your smaller stamps and dies as well. It works an absolute treat.